Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Millionaire Dentist Podcast, brought to you by Four Quadrants Advisory. On this podcast, we break down the world of dentistry finances and business practices to help you become the millionaire dentist you deserve to be. Please be advised, we do speak with an honest tongue and may not be safe for work.
Hello and welcome. This is Casey Hiers back at the Millionaire Dentist Podcast in studio with co-host Jarrod Bridgeman.
Casey, how are you?
Sweater collection's on point, man.
Thank you. I'm a big fan of sweaters, and I'm glad it's getting chillier outside because I can get to break them out.
You know? Sweaters. I'm about to dust mine off.
Casey, you know, next week you're going to be heading to Orlando, and that's Florida, by the way, for those of you that don't know. We're heading to Orlando, Florida, and you're going to be presenting some CE. Can you walk me through about our CE course in general?
Webster's Dictionary defines CE as continuing education. I can tell you why dentists and specialists tell me they come.
Okay.
And yeah, this one, what's the name of it?
Highball and Harvest.
Highball and Harvest at the Ritz-Carlton.
Right.
I mean, number one, people come, and this is in no particular order.
All right.
We have it at kick-ass places.
For sure.
Highball and Harvest at the Orlando Ritz-Carlton. We're not messing around. This is a fantastic venue. And we like to do that. I mean, we've got some things coming up in 2024. I mean, we might be bottling our own bourbon with a label. I mean, we're going next level. But
well, because you know, we want something that's nice, but something that's also not that's still somewhat original, like really nice and original. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I when we pick venues, I want it to be someplace where if we have a client that lives there and I mention this to them, they go, "Oh yeah, that's one of the best spots ever." Like we went there for our anniversary last year. That's our goal, number one. And so people are going to go because it's going to be somewhere that's nice, it's comfortable. It's not. I don't want to make fun of any restaurant.
Sure,
so
sure.
Yeah, but we like to have it a nice venue. Ultimately, I have sat in on a lot of dental CE. Like when I go to courses and present, I'll slide in different places. You know, if I'm not at the cabana, right? And there's so much of it. And so much of it, it's one idea. And it's just very basic. Our chief operations officer has done the same thing. There's also some really, really good CE.
Sure.
Don't get me wrong. But there's so much out there, it's hard to discern what's worth your time. Mm-hmm. I will tell you what past people have told us. They've said things like, this topic probably matters to my family, my legacy, and my money in retirement more than anything I've heard. Yet I don't get a lot of this.
Well, what is the topic?
How to master the business side of dentistry.
Yeah.
How to understand that most CEs and most CEOs in the country are also not the primary producers.
Correct.
In dentistry, you are the CEO, you wear at least five other C-level executive hats, and you are also the primary producer. It's kind of a raw deal, and dentistry is great, but a lot of young dentists do not understand practice ownership is really, really challenging. You can be terrible at it and still make $300,000 a year in dentistry. We've seen people make $600,000 or $700,000 in dentistry and not be very good at the business. Actually, not maybe 920 be the, you know, like somebody coming in going help.
But comparatively, like if they had already been with us, how much of that would have been? How much of that would have changed?
Oh, we play that game all the time.
Yeah,
yeah. I mean, it's a huge number, but the point is there's a lot of CE out there. A lot of times the place will get somebody's attention, but the ones I like the most are the ones that come for the subject matter.
Right.
They recognize it. They go, man, I'm damn successful, but I feel like I've hit a plateau in a lot of this cash flow, insurance, overhead.
They've done it to the best of their abilities and don't know what to do next.
Yeah. So the people that see that subject matter on the business side of dentistry and go, yeah, I want to go there. But the other, you know, one of the other ones you mentioned before we started recording, amongst their peers.
Yeah.
Because at study clubs, there's peacocking and posturing and posing. And
is it because they kind of know each other enough to?
They're kind of competitors.
Yeah.
This one's a little different. Like our events, I feel like there is a camaraderie amongst the attendees because they don't all know each other. Some of them do.
They may have heard.
But they're familiar with each other. So that's nice. I've had pediatric dentists or specialists actually do some referral work on the before and after, which kudos, like
a little bit of networking.
I love that.
Yeah.
You know, and so it's interesting when they look around the room, they're trying to see, are these people like me? Mm. And while the practices can be different and the situations can be different, ultimately they are like you because they recognize that this is a huge challenge. They've had their enough clinical CE or one trick pony CE that they're all kind of in the same boat. But I say that I also have had people that are almost giving up on dentistry because they can't.
They may be on different levels of frustration.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah, it's a good way to put it. Yeah, but ultimately, I mean, I've had people tell me, Casey, it's like you've looked at all of my financials. How do you know? Somebody recently, actually, as a podcast listener, goes, it felt like the timing was unbelievable. Everything that I've been thinking about and worrying about and contemplating, you hit on one after the other, to the point where I looked around and go, these must be paid actors and actresses. And this is really a setup for me, because this is just dead bullseye.
Right.
So again, we get to the heart of things, and it's intense.
But it's intense. It's informative. It really makes you think, but also it's not a total mental beatdown. We also include food and drink along with that as well, or golf if it's at a top.
Well, it's like a good workout. Right. It might hurt, but you're better because of it. I say that sometimes at the opening, because I'm getting them ready, because some of them look like they've seen a ghost when I hit on some of this stuff. You know, how did he know that? Well, we've been mastering it for 20 years. That's how we know it. I think I mentioned this earlier, but I had somebody go, are you a dentist? And felt like a dentist added credibility to our subject matter. And I laughed and I said, well, no, dentists don't know how to do this. That would be like me trying to do dentistry right now.
Right.
And they weren't even a practice owner. That was the funny part. But no, we've been mastering this for Quadrants Advisory. Has been doing it for a long time. We're in a growth mode.
So tell me, besides the venue, besides the networking, we've got the CE. Can you tell me, is there any other wow factors that you do that really, really wraps people into this event?
I mean, it depends on what people are into. You know, the best outcomes are the ones that they're crushing it. They've hit a plateau and they go, Casey, does your firm help this? Because I try to make the CE about the problems and issues.
Right.
I take off the four quadrant cape.
Yep.
But yeah, the best ones are the folks that go, I would love to chat privately.
Right.
And then ultimately go through a vetting process. We're not deciding to work together. We're deciding to engage in a process to see if we can help you buy millions of dollars. And so those are the best outcomes. But sure, we're tasting bourbon. We're enjoying wonderful food. I mean, again, we're going to the best places to enjoy right. all their culinary delights.
Right.
Most of the time I just look at them, because as a presenter, I don't like to be on a too full of a stomach. So, you know, I'm trying to play the martyr card here.
But you do your little snack beforehand. And
yeah.
Yeah.
But no, it's we're efficient. We're respectful with people's times. If we do a bourbon tasting, there's a bourbon raffle. You know, again, when we're doing heavy hitting topics, yep. That cause, you know, work-life balance and relationship with kids and wives. I mean, money affects everything.
I've been in events. I've been to a couple of your events when you're presenting. And I think a lot of people also appreciate the fact that you are timely and efficient, and that, you know, we start on time.
Yeah, no, for the most part, we want to do that as well. But, you know, we've got a handful of, I think, spots left. The cool thing is we go to venues where it's pretty exclusive.
Right.
There's only a few spots left, but for Orlando, I think we do have a handful left. And so it's one of those things, simply click on a link, register. There's a $50 placeholder fully yep. refunded once you attend.
Right.
We had too many people saying they were going to come that affected the venue size and a whole bunch of details. And, you know, we didn't need a bunch of slap dicks from Facebook that weren't even dentists trying to come to our events. And so,
right. Or, you know, people, you know, I know, dentists get frustrated when they get no shows.
I have had people come to the events because they needed dental work. I've had an Amazon driver that said he delivers dental stuff. So, I mean, I've seen a lot. This event is for, in a perfect world, practice-owning dentists who are ready to go to the next step. But at minimum, you know, dentists and specialists that have a...
And by the way, spouses as well.
Oh, sure.
So bring your husband, bring your wife, bring whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, we love that. I mean, it has to do with dentistry. But it's how it affects your personal life too.
Right. If they become a client of ours, that the spouse plays a pretty important part of that.
Well, and here's the other thing. We're not selling timeshares. Sure. There may be one or two people that we end up helping in any room that we're in. We can't help everybody.
Right.
And so our business model doesn't lend to a quantity shop that we're just trying to get people quote unquote signed up. That's the opposite. We actually say no more than we say yes. But it does introduce us to nice new folks who may need some help. But
what's a worst case scenario if a doc comes to one of our events?
You get some free food, you meet some people in your industry, and you hear something that might be thought provoking.
Right.
Some people will get defensive because I've hit on something that's a nerve, you know. So maybe somebody comes away a little bit irked, but ultimately if,
you know, the next day though, they're like, shit, he was right.
Well, if, you know, the emotional IQ and sort of the self-awareness is where it needs to be, ultimately they're going to be like, yeah, that bothered me for a reason because I need to work on it. Yep. And a lot of people get takeaways too of these two things. I have now a more clear vision of what good or great looks like. So absolutely.
Well, and this is going to be November 9th, which is
Thursday
of next week, which will be pretty exciting for you. And I also know we have a really, really great place picked out in Phoenix as well.
Scottsdale, to be precise, Olive and Ivy, that place rocks.
Yep. So that'll be a great one. Mm. And then after that, in December, we're going to be in Louisville, Kentucky.
Louisville. Love it.
But hey, listen, if you are interested in attending one of our events,
register, bring a friend, bring a spouse.
That's right. Register as many people as you want to bust out that, you know, those referrals for, and go to fourquadrantsadvisory.com/events, and you'll see all of our upcoming events and click on the one you want to go to and fill out the form. Thanks, Casey.
That's all the time we have today. Thank you to our guests for their insight and for sharing some really great information. And thank you to you, the listener, for tuning in. The Millionaire Dentist Podcast is brought to you by Four Quadrants Advisory. To see if they might be a good fit for you and your practice, go on over to fourquadrantsadvisory.com and see why year after year, they retain over 95% of their clients. Thank you again for joining us, and we'll see you next time.